The value of Beardsley diagrams is especially evident with compound arguments. Remember that a compound argument is an argument that contains at least one proposition that is the conclusion of a smaller argument while also serving as the premise of a larger argument. Now, because there are multiple levels in the Beardsley diagram of a compound argument, there's a mistake that commonly appears. In the diagram on the left, we see that there's an arrow leading from proposition 4 to a plus sign. That doesn't mean anything. In the diagram on the right, on the other hand, the arrow is leading to the number 2. That is correct. Arrows should never lead to plus signs. The reason I think that students do this is because they see that there are sometimes propositions, like proposition 4, that support more than one proposition. So, for example, proposition 4 might be supporting both propositions 2 and 3. There are two different ways we can represent this. First, we can write the number 4 twice and have an arrow leading from each of them to the propositions that it supports. Or you can just write the number 4 once and have arrows leading to each of the other propositions. Because compound arguments are frequently quite complex, we need a method for dealing with them. And the method that we're going to use is called chunking. Consider this example. Capitalism has generated more wealth than any other economic system in history. However, it has also led to many problems. The profit motive is often at odds with environmental protection, many people are reduced to poverty, and capitalist economies are prone to crashes. That's why capitalism is a mixed bag, and thus why some regulation of capitalist economies is warranted. As with any Beardsley diagram, we begin by bracketing and numbering. Next, we want to break this passage down into smaller elements. That is, we want to see if there are any propositions that work together. In this case, notice propositions 2, 3, 4, and 5. Quite clearly, propositions 3, 4, and 5 support proposition number 2. So we can draw a preliminary diagram representing this. Going back to the passage, notice that proposition 6, that capitalism is a mixed bag, is supported by the conjunction of propositions 1 and 2. That is, it's a mixed bag because it has done something very positive, that is, generated more wealth than any other economic system in history, but it has also led to many problems. We can then add propositions 1 and 6 to our diagram. So 1 plus 2 leads to 6. Finally, we have proposition 7, some regulation of capitalist economies is warranted. Notice how that final sentence reads. That's why 6, capitalism is a mixed bag, and thus why 7, some regulation of capitalist economies is warranted. The conclusion indicator thus tells us that proposition 7 follows immediately from 6. Again, we can add that to our diagram, and we're done. The lesson of all this is that we can make constructing Beardsley diagrams for compound arguments a lot easier by doing two things. First, chunk the passages into smaller units. We can draw Beardsley diagrams of those smaller units and then fit them together. Secondly, pay very close attention to indicator words within passages. Those can tell us a lot about the structure of larger arguments and can make constructing diagrams a lot easier.